GLA, and Audi hopes it'll compete with cars like the BMW 335, the Infiniti G37, and the Lexus IS350C convertibles. The S5 has a lot going for it. It's powerful, but surprisingly easy to drive and pretty accommodating too. That said, some may wonder why Audi didn't go with a folding metal hardtop like those others did. The S5, like the S4, has a 3-liter supercharged V6. Now, why they chose to put V6T here, I don't get, and as a rider, it kind of offends me. But the engine doesn't. It's good for 333 horsepower, 325 pound-feet of torque, and that latter figure is available from 2,900 all the way up through 5,300 RPM. Still, not as low of a torque peak as a lot of turbocharged cars, so there's not a ton of thrust early on. Fortunately, the car makes up for that when you rev up high. There's plenty of acceleration. Now, like a lot of Audis, the steering is pretty easy at low speeds and it firms up at higher speeds, but the car still feels a little bit nose-heavy, even with Audi's rear-biased quattro all-wheel drive. Still, this is one of those convertibles that doesn't require a lot of compromises to drive. Snowbelt drivers will appreciate the availability of all-wheel drive, and Audi's got a lot of little things going on here too. Stuff like a center armrest here that adjusts forward and extends outward for shorter drivers, seatbelt extenders that move forward when you get in the car so you don't have to reach around so much to get to them, and a back seat that adults might actually find tolerable for short trips. So why did Audi go with a soft top instead of a hard top? Well, the automaker says it did so for reasons of weight, of size, packaging, ease of use. Those arguments do have some value. The S5's soft top weighs less than the 3 Series, the G37, and the IS's hard tops. It also goes up and down in less than 20 seconds. Some of those other cars take up to 30 seconds to do their thing. It also takes up a lot less space in the trunk, maybe 20-25%, although Audi doesn't provide us with exact figures. A lot less space than the folding hardtops, which are big, heavy contraptions. And Audi hopes it'll compete with cars like the BMW 335, the Infiniti G37, and the Lexus IS350C convertibles. The S5 has a lot going for it. It's powerful, but surprisingly easy to drive and pretty accommodating too. That said, some may wonder why Audi didn't go with a folding metal hardtop like those others did. The S5, like the S4, has a 3-liter supercharged V6. Now, why they chose to put V6T here, I don't get, and as a rider, it kind of offends me. But the engine doesn't. It's good for 333 horsepower, 325 pound-feet of torque, and that latter figure is available from 2,900 all the way up through 5,300 RPM. Still, not as low of a torque peak as a lot of turbocharged cars, so there's not a ton of thrust early on. Fortunately, the car makes up for that when you rev up high. There's plenty of acceleration.